Now, children, practice set 3.4, first sum. Point A is on the bisector of angle X, Y, Z. If AX is 2, then how much is AZ? So let us write down now, ray YA is the bisector, of angle X, Y, Z. And what else is given in the question? Segment AX perpendicular to ray Y, segment AX perpendicular to ray YX and segment AZ perpendicular to ray YZ. Therefore, we can write length of AX is same as length of AZ, and this is by angle bisector theorem. Now, what is angle bisector theorem? Angle bisector theorem states that any point which lies, on the bisector of the angle is equidistant from the arms of the angle. I repeat, any point which lies on the bisector of the angle is equidistant from the arms of the angle. So according to the statement, AX becomes equal to AZ. And how much is AX? AX is 2. It is equal to 2 centimeter. So AZ will also be equal to 2 centimeters. Therefore, length AX is equal to length AZ is equal to 2 centimeters. Therefore, length of AZ is equal to 2 centimeters is equal to 2 centimeters. We are making use of the theorem, angle bisector theorem. Any point which lies on the bisector is equidistant from the arms of the angle. And which angle we are talking about? Angle X, Y, Z. We are talking about angle X, Y, Z. Now, in the next picture, children, angle RST is given as 50, this complete angle. PT is perpendicular to ray ST. PR is perpendicular to ray PR is perpendicular to the ray PR is perpendicular to the ray SR, and PR is congruent to PT. Children, here it is already given that this length is same as this length, which means this point P is equidistant from the arms. This point P is equidistant from ST and ray SR. Then what we have to prove? We have to prove that SP, ray SP, is the bisector of angle TSR. Children, this is just the opposite of the top one. In the top one, what was given? A lies on the bisector, so it is equidistant. And here what they have given? This point P is equidistant from the arms on the angle. Therefore, ray SP becomes the bisector. So let us write down now. Segment, look here. Segment PT perpendicular to ray ST. And what is the second thing given? Segment PR perpendicular to ray SR. This is also given. And what is the third thing given? Segment PR congruent to segment PT. All these three statements are given to us in the question. Therefore, ray SP is the bisector of angle TSR. So we will write here converse of angle bisector theorem. What is the reason? Converse of angle bisector theorem. Now, if SP is the bisector, then what can we say? We can say that this angle, this bubble angle, is same as this bubble angle. So let us write down the name angle RSP. RSP is equal to angle TSP. Is equal to angle TSP. TSP. Okay. Now, what is our bigger angle TSR made up of? TSR, this bigger angle, is made up of two smaller angles. Which are those? TSP, TSP plus angle PSR, PSR. And this is called as angle addition property. It is called as angle addition property. Children, in the question, angle RST or TSR is given to us as 56 degrees. How much it is given to us as 56 degrees. Now what we can do? What we can do is, in place of TSP, I can write angle PSR plus angle PSR. This PSR as it is. And in place of TSP, I have written here PSR. Children, what is PSR? PSR is same as RS. See, PSR is same as RSP. PSR is same as RSP. Let me write this down again so there will be no confusion. Now it is better. Okay, now children, see. Now, in place of TSP, I have written here PSR. This PSR is same as RSP. PSR is same as RSP. Okay. So, let me call this as 1. Let me call this as 2. So, this is from 1 and 2. So, 56 is equal to double of angle PSR. Therefore, angle PSR is equal to 56 by 2, which is equal to 28 degrees. So, angle PSR is equal to 28 degrees. And what is your PSR? Your PSR is same as RSP. Therefore, angle RSP is equal to 28 degrees. That is equal to 28 degrees. Okay. Now, practice set 3.4, sixth question. Children, you can see triangle ABC is given to us. AD is perpendicular to side BC. Okay. AD is perpendicular to side BC. And AD is also the bisector of angle BAC. Okay. Triangle ABC. AD is perpendicular to BC. And AD is also the bisector of angle BAC. So, we have to show that triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means what we have to get is, towards the end we have to get AB. In triangle ABC, side AB is congruent to side AC. So, till we get that step, we are going to work. And what we are supposed to get, side AB is congruent to side AC. Okay, children. Now, this sum is same as the converse of isosceles triangle theorem. Okay. Now, let us come to the triangle. In triangle ABD, the left hand side, and let us come to the right hand side. And triangle ACD. ACD. We know that AD is the bisector of angle A. So, we are getting two angles here with the cross, two angles here with the cross. And we also know that AD is the bisector. So both these angles will be 90 degrees. So let us write down the elements now. Angle BAD, which is that angle? Angle BAD, congruent to angle CAD, congruent to angle CAD. Now let us write down this 90 degree. Angle ADB, ADB, congruent to angle ADC. This is because AD is perpendicular to BC, and this is because AD is the bisector. AD is the bisector. Now you can see, children, this side AD is common. So segment AD congruent to segment AD. So the two triangles are congruent by what test? Angle, side, angle test. Once again, angle, side, angle test. So that is ASA test. Triangle ABD congruent to angle ACD by what test? Angle, side, angle test. ASA test. Now, therefore, we can say segment AB congruent to segment AC. What is the reason? Corresponding sides of congruent triangles. I repeat, corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Therefore, in a triangle, when I get any two sides as equal, I can say the triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Is an isosceles triangle. And what do we write at the end? We write it as hence proved. We write it as hence proved.